welcome to One Church. No matter who you are, no matter what you've done, and no matter what's been done to you, Jesus is for you. If this is your first time, a very special welcome to you. Would you take a second and head to our website, church.one, fill the Connect card out. This helps us know a little bit more about who you are and how we can be praying for you. Here at One Church, we continue to pray for one person to share God's love with every day. A great way to share God's love with someone right now is to invite them to watch service with you. Take a second and share the service link with somebody that God puts on your heart. Music is one of the ways that we worship our God, and right now we're gonna do that. We're gonna sing songs, we're gonna lift our voice, we're gonna open our hearts, and we're gonna give it all to the King.
Here we go!
Those walls that we call sin and shame, they were like prisons that we couldn't escape. But he came and he died and he rose. And what? Those walls are rubble now, yes, because of you, Jesus. Remember those giants we call death and grave. They were like mountains that stood in the way. But he came, and he died, and he rose. Those giants are dead now.
Amen to that truth today. Sing of our God.
And this is our God. This is who he is. He loves us. And this is our God. This is what he does.
no time like right now to take a next step with Jesus, you can head to our website, church.one. You can fill the connect card out. Somebody will connect back with you. You can make a decision to be baptized or join a group, but take a next step with Jesus today. We want to reach the most people in the shortest time, and our YouTube channel is helping us to do that. Welcome to all of our new subscribers. If you haven't done so already, make sure that you subscribe. Turn that notifications bell on to stay caught up with everything we have going on here at One Church. What a gift it is to take what God has blessed us with and to entrust it back to Him. We want to thank you so much for your continued generosity. If you'd like to give at any time during our service, here's how you can do that. We love to celebrate what God's doing here at One Church, and we do that each week with our high five. Check it out now.
Up at number five, we continue to celebrate the many ways God moved Easter weekend. With 24 worship services having taken place over the weekend, people encountered Jesus, and we're celebrating 22 baptisms across all of our outposts. Whether you were with us online or in person, high five to worshiping our risen Savior together. In at number four, our worship staff took to Eastern Nazarene College in Quincy, Mass. This past Tuesday for a night of worship. There, they spent sweet time praising God with the students there and sharing about what we're experiencing God doing here in New England. High five to more times like these. Here at number three, participants of Rooted are past the halfway mark in their 10-week journey. Way to go, you guys. This time in His presence is sweet. High five to all those in Rooted this spring. Way to grow strong roots in God's love. Up at number two, students from our Manchester and Concord outpost enjoyed another 603 night where they gathered together for games, worship, a meal, and a message. Students gather every Wednesday evening at our Manchester and Concord outposts, and there are many more 603 nights to look forward to. So head to church.one/students to find out more, and we'll see you at the next one. And finally, up at number one, we're celebrating 14 baptisms across all of our outposts this past weekend. High five to Adam, Steve, Savannah, Sarah, Caroline, Ethan, Deborah, Arianna, Aiden, Sarah, Rosemary, Kevin, Tim, and Joseph. We're so excited for how God will continue to work in and through you. Thanks for joining us for our high five, and I can't wait to celebrate with you in the next one.
We love watching people begin to believe that God is for us and not against us. And that's coming from someone that thought that God was against me before I realized that He was for me. I thought based on everything that I'd done, the things that I didn't do that I thought He wanted me to do, that God was like, no, Mike, I'm all set with you. And He never felt like that. He was actually like, oh, Mike, I love you and I'm for you. I enjoy you and I want to have a relationship with you. And when my heart discovered that, everything changed. And so one of the things we love about One Church is over and over again, people are discovering the love of God, that this love, this beauty of Jesus is really for each and every one of us. That's why we're doing a message series called This Is For Everyone, because we truly believe that this is for everyone. Everyone we know, everyone we work with, everyone we hang with, everyone we go to class with, that the love of God is for everyone that we lock eyes with. That over and over, God extends invitations to the people that He loves. And in This Is For Everyone, we're gonna celebrate some of those invitations. And the one that we celebrate today is this invitation of baptism. Now, I don't know what you think when you hear the word baptism. Maybe you thought about, hey, I was a baby and I was sprinkled, or I was an adult and I had this really sweet experience, or I was watching the high five from One Church and I saw a bunch of people in a hot tub and like, what's up with that? Baptism, it's beautiful. Baptism is this moment where we understand that Jesus went all in for us in our hearts, in our minds, in our bodies, respond to what He did on our behalf. And we're like, you know what? I'm gonna say yes to that. I'm gonna say yes to the love of God. I'm gonna say yes to the forgiveness of God. I'm gonna say yes to this invitation. Now, baptism, it's one of the moments where we can clearly identify, okay, God is at work in our lives. I'm convinced that God is working every minute of every day in each and every one of our lives. But I know there's been moments where I've been unaware of that. We're never unaware of it when we're wet. Just not. We're just like, when we're wet from the top of our head to the bottom of our feet and just saturated in the love of God, we're like, I'm aware God is working. And I just want each and every one of us to experience this beautiful thing. So it's a moment that we say yes with our mind, with our heart, and with our body. Now, one of the things that always kind of surprised me about baptism was in the Bible, Jesus was baptized. And back in Jesus's day, when he was baptized, baptism was a sign or a symbol of repentance. Like, it was typically for people that didn't know that God was for them. They might have thought that God was against them, and they discovered for the first time, okay, God, you are for me, you pursue me, you want relationship with me. Jesus knew that entirely for eternity, and yet he steps into the waters of baptism. The dude that was baptizing, his name was literally John the Baptist. John's like, whoa, whoa, Jesus, I think you're exempt from this. Like, you don't need this. And he's like, no, I'm not exempt. I want this. I want this because it's a way for me to identify with the people that I love. And years later, we want baptism because it's a way to identify with the Lord that we love. Like, Jesus was baptized. Another reason that we want to be baptized is because Jesus told his people to be baptized. So as Jesus' people, again, God is for us. He's not against us. He's constantly communicating that to us. We're like, okay, if there is something that I can do that you're telling me to do, Jesus, I want to do that thing. So if you're here, and you love Jesus, Jesus is the Lord and the Savior of your life, I want to encourage you to respond to this invitation of baptism. Now, there's questions about baptism. I get them fairly often. I get to serve as an outpost pastor with one church. I'm typically at the Manchester outpost. So people will send an email, a call, and be like, hey, again, I'm watching people get baptized, but I don't totally understand it. And so I'll say, okay. Baptism is when we believe that Jesus Christ is God, that he lived, he died, he was buried, and he rose again, all to handle my sin, to offer me salvation. If I've received that, if I believe in that, then I would ask you or encourage you to say yes to baptism. Because when we say yes to Jesus, our soul is already connected with him, and baptism symbolizes that. There's also questions that I get, like, from parents or grandparents, sometimes guardians. They were like, hey, my son or daughter, my grandchildren are asking about baptism. And I'm like, oh, dude, that must be so cool. They're like, well, what do I say? I'm like, well, what are they saying? They're like, I want to be baptized. I'm like, okay, cool. Let's use this language with them. If a child is old enough to understand what sin is, sin is anytime I do anything that God doesn't want me to do, I sin. Anytime I don't do something that God does want me to do, I sin. If a child can understand that, if a child can understand that sin brings death, but Jesus Christ died on a cross, again, died, buried, resurrected to take away our sin and give us life. If they can grasp that, let's celebrate. Let's have a party. Let's let them be baptized. And if they're not there yet, let's hold off. But that's kind of our metric of, do they understand how awesome Jesus is? And then the last question I get a decent amount is, hey, does a pastor have to baptize me? A priest? Do I have to go to a church building? Like who's involved? And I'm like, oh no, like, we don't have to baptize you. We'd love to, but we don't have to. One of the things that made me super happy in the last 2 weeks is that my buddy baptized his buddy. My buddy that worked with his buddy for 20 years, they've been through all kinds of things together. Dudes that love each other and live life with each other. Someone that's been praying for his friend for years, he got to baptize his buddy a couple weeks back. Wow. I got to watch it and I was just like, this is wild. This is so, so good. My buddy called me that night and he's like, dude, I baptized my boy. I was like, yeah, man, I was there, I saw it. And he's like, this is a big deal. I was like, this is an extremely big deal. The next day, I couldn't shake it. I found myself texting him. And I'm like, bro, I'm still blown away by last night. He's like, I am too. I'm like, can you believe God is using our lives? He's like, no. And I just wrote, miracles happen. And he's like, absolutely. Like, we get to be a part of something so special and so significant. Oh, and I'm so, so thankful. So baptism is an incredible invitation. It is for anyone who is like, Jesus is my Lord and Jesus is my Savior. It is extended to everyone because this is for everyone. We have a memory verse for every message series. And our memory verse for this is for everyone is Romans 10, verse 13. I would love for you to read this out loud because it's really sweet hearing the word of God come out of our mouths. It goes like this. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Come on. Like it does not get better than that. Anyone who's like, Jesus, you're my Lord, you're my Savior, that person is saved. And because anyone and everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved, we want everyone who does so to repent and be baptized. Now, I don't know how you hear these two words. If you hear repent and you're like, someone told me to repent before and they were angry. I get it. Like repentance and repenting has been a church word that's been leveraged in some weird ways. We're not using it like that. Like repentance and baptism are equally beautiful invitations extended to each and every one of us. Repentance is just when I change my mind. Because again, there was a moment that I didn't know that God was for me. I thought he was against me. But repentance believes, no, God, you are for me. Jesus died for me. I have eternal life because he died, was buried, and rose again. I see that now. I see you as love. I see other people the way that you see them, and I begin to see myself the way that you see me. Repentance is a new lens of life that we all get to have. And when we have that lens, when we accept that lens, we can step into baptism in beautiful ways. We're looking at the letter of Romans in the New Testament, specifically chapter 6. We're gonna read this. It's really, really sweet. Romans 6, verse 1. What shall we say then? Shall we go on sinning so that grace may increase? By no means. We are those who have died to sin. How can we live in it any longer? Or don't you know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. This is woohoo for sure. This is really wonderful news. In Romans chapter 6, we're seeing an old life, new life distinction. God is against me versus God is for me distinction. Before I had a new lens versus I am loved by God distinction. And again, when we step into this invitation that God has for us, this invitation of Jesus, this invitation of going all in with Jesus, this invitation of baptism, in that we are unified with Jesus. So in baptism, we are unified with Jesus in his death. Romans 6 talks a lot about sin. Again, we define sin as anytime I do something God doesn't want me to do, or anytime I do not do something God does want me to do, I sin. But it's not just there. Anytime someone does something to me that God doesn't want them to do to me, their sin impacts me. Or anytime someone doesn't do for me what God does want them to do for me, they sin against me and their sin impacts me. So my sin hits people, people's sin hits me. I don't know what to do with my sin, and I don't know what to do with the sin of the people that are sinning towards me. The only thing I have is Jesus. In the death of Jesus, this incredible historical moment that changed the world forever and everyone in it, it helps me understand that sin can die. Sin can die. Like what I feel of it, it can die because Jesus died on a cross for my sin. Sin has ended. I know it might not feel like it, and I understand that we still feel the effects of it, but in a very real, wonderful way, sin is totally defeated because in Jesus Christ, sin died in him. In baptism, we are unified with Jesus in his burial. Sometimes I wonder, what's up with 3 days? Like, what's up with Jesus coming off a cross and going in a tomb? Like, what's happening there? And I think it's just to communicate to my heart, especially when I'm struggling, that sin really is dead. Because sin died in Jesus and it stayed dead in Jesus for 3 days. And when Jesus gloriously rose from the grave, you know what didn't rise? Sin. Sin stayed stuck dead where it should be. Man, I'm a broken person. When I said that I know what it feels like to be like our God is against me, there's a reason that I've thought that. It's because I'm not perfect, because I struggle, because I'm like you, because we're not perfect. And we struggle. And sometimes we think, man, I don't know if I'll ever be free. I don't know if I'll ever stop fighting this thing that seems to own me. Guys, girls, we can be free. I know it, I'm feeling it. And I'm not saying I'm perfect because that would be a lie, but I am saying I'm not who I was. Because Jesus buried sin, and sin doesn't own us. And then in baptism, we are unified with Jesus in his resurrection. If this is real, we celebrated Easter a couple weeks ago. If this is real, if Jesus is really alive, our lives, we have new life. If Jesus is alive and we've trusted in him, we have new life. The impossible is possible. We get to walk in that. And so this idea of repent and be baptized, it's a beautiful extension. And I hope we're like, yeah. I hope you're like, yes. Yes, I will repent and be baptized because it's so good. In addition to that, like we want to be baptized and be free. We want to be baptized and be free. I'm going to keep reading Romans 6. I'll pick up in verse 4. It reads like this. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly also be united with him in a resurrection like his. For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves to sin. Because anyone who has died has been set free from sin. Now, if we died with sin, we believe that we also live with him. For we know that since Christ was raised from the dead, he cannot die again. Death no longer has mastery over him. The death he died to sin once for all, but the life he lives to God. We get to be baptized and we get to be free because Jesus in his death, burial, and resurrection makes us free. And this is for us. I promise there were moments that I thought I was stuck doing things I didn't want to do, not doing things I did want to do. And I thought that the only thing that would change that would be death. like I will never change. I feel so stuck and so hopeless. And it wasn't true. Because Jesus is alive and he is miraculous and wonderful and he works in our worlds in incredible ways. I don't know if you've been putting off baptism because you're like, I don't have my life together yet. We're never gonna get there. I promise we will not have our life together enough to be baptized. It's not the invitation anyways. The invitation is go all in with Jesus because he went all in for us. And when we do, we begin to experience freedom. This Romans letter talks a ton about the fight of sin, the struggle with sin. And so much of it, again, is tied to old life, new life. God is against me versus God is for me. And I can only speak personally. Well, I can speak personally and what I've observed. I know there's been moments where I would just cry out, God, change this, change this, change this. I want to stop this. I want to stop this. I want to stop this. Meanwhile, I'm so focused on this that I'm still stuck in this. And something changed. I had a guy in my life. He was an incredible mentor, pastor, father figure. And I would spend time with him. And I'd be like, hey, man, I feel like I'm a terrible husband. And I feel like I'm a terrible friend. I feel like I'm a terrible pastor. I just feel terrible. I would just like give all my guts to him. And he would look at me at the end of 60, 90 minutes. And he would say, Michael, you're a man of God. I love you and God loves you. And I'd be like, you're not listening. You're not listening to what I'm saying. Open your ears. Michael, my ears are open. I heard everything you said. You are a man of God. I love you and God loves you. And what he was doing was being a voice of God in my life. Because the more I focused on, I can't, I can't, I can't, I'm stuck, I'm stuck, I'm stuck. I stayed stuck. The moment I focused on, all right, I am loved and I am free and Jesus died for me and I'm in him because I've been baptized into him. That's the moment my world, my lens changed. What I got. This is what we have. The reason every day we ask everybody to pray for one is because we're not focusing on what mess I'm in. I'm focused on, okay, God, you're going to use my life today. And yes, I might be a mess, but that does not mean you're not going to use my life today. And I hope I'm growing, but God, the one thing I know for sure is that you're going to use my life today. But God, I can't share what I don't have. So before I share your love with anybody, I need you to fill me up with your love. Remind me who I am. I am yours. You are for me. And let me go to work like that. And let me go to school like that. And let me hang out with my neighbors and my friends like that. Let me be that. So today, right now, I would love to pray for one together because God fills us with his love and then his love flows through us. So if you would, this prayer goes like this. God, please give me one person to share your love with. Would you pray that out loud with me? God, please give me one person to share your love with. Yeah, it's so, so good. That's our freedom. So we're gonna be baptized and we're gonna be free. And then we're gonna be free and we're gonna be graceful. We're gonna be free and we're going to be graceful. Romans 6, verse 11 goes like this. In the same way, count yourself dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body so that you obey its desires. And do not offer any part of yourself to sin as an instrument of wickedness, but rather offer yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life. And offer every part of yourself to him as an instrument of righteousness. For sin shall no longer be your master because you are not under the law, but under grave. We are free. And because we're free, we're graceful. We are full of grace. We ooze grace. Grace flows out of us to the people that are around us. We get excited to share good things. Like I get pumped to share good things. And grace is a really good thing. Baptism is a really good thing. When I'm texting my buddy about baptizing his buddy, and I'm telling my buddies that my buddy baptized his buddy, and in the beauty and the wonder of that moment, I'm sharing good things. When you step into baptism and what God has for your life, and you invite someone to be a part of that that has been significant in you discovering that God is for you and not against you, that Jesus knows you and he wants you, in that, it's sharing good things. I watched my buddy's buddy's family as he was baptized. Like I was just in the background. I'm just chilling. I'm watching. And I'm watching smiles, and I'm watching tears, and I'm watching wonder, and I'm watching other people wonder, is that for me too? Is that for me too? Every time we say yes to Jesus, every time we take a step of faith, the people around us watching us take steps of faith are like, I can take a step of faith. And so I want to ask, like, what is that step of faith? How are we graceful, and how does grace flow out of our lives? One way. Is by saying yes to Jesus in baptism. We'd love to celebrate this with you. Let me be clear, you don't need us to celebrate this, but if you want us to be a part of it, we want to be a part of this with you. Church.one, if you go there and fill out a Connect card, the first thing that pops up when you punch that in, church.one, it's Connect card. One of the things on the Connect card is, I want to be baptized. If you fill that out, someone on our team will follow up. They'll touch base. We'll connect the dots. We will make it happen. If you feel that God is putting that on your heart, please say yes to God. It's going to be a gift for you, and it's going to be a gift for the people around you. It's a step of faith that will encourage others to take steps of faith. This is for us, because Jesus is for us. And we know, we can know, in the depths of who we are, that Jesus, you are for me. And another way that we drive this deep into our hearts and deep into our minds is by remembering what Jesus Christ did on the cross for us and remembering communion. Now, if you have bread and juice, you are invited to participate, but that's not the only way to participate. Just remembering Jesus, remembering his sacrifice, his love, his life, his death, his burial, his resurrection, that being for me and that being for you, that being for everyone. So this wafer, this bread, represents the body of Jesus. It takes us back to the Last Supper when Jesus looked at his friends, and he said, this bread represents my body, and I'm giving my body for you. Jesus says yes to you. If you are saying yes to Jesus, would you please take this with me? That same night, Jesus took the cup. He proposed a toast. He said, the contents of this cup represent my blood, and my blood is going to be poured out for the forgiveness of sin, for anyone, for everyone. Anyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved, and it's because of this incredibly generous act that Christ did on our behalf. So Jesus says yes to us. If we're saying yes to Jesus, please take this with me.
So glad that you joined us today for our worship service. We're here every week and we'd love to have you join us again. So from all of us here at One Church, have a good one.